So if you look at the architecture team here, right, as I mentioned, if we are talking about sales and operations planning to be enabled within IBP, there is a dedicated planning area which SAP has provided as out-of-box functionality. We call it as a unified planning area. Right? What does unified planning area covers? It has standard predefined master data, standard predefined key figures already available, and a logical sequence of demand planning or supply review exists there. On top of it, we have a free hand to create any additional master data, additional attributes or key figures. Right? So if somebody has a question that what do we mean by attribute? So if we try to relate to a ECC system, right? And let's take an example of material master. So material master is one of my master data. And within material masters, I have different fields, right? MRP type is one of the field that becomes an attribute from IBP perspective. So you can relate the terminologies here, right? This dedicated planning area you can use and model your IBP system. You can have your own attributes, key figures. Within this planning area, we can have simulation enabled using different scenarios, as I mentioned. SAP has also provided analytics within IBP in different terms. You can have alerts, demand planning alerts or Excel-based alerts created, which can be reviewed using Excel UI. Alerts in terms of web UI, there is a dedicated app provided by SAP where it is user-friendly to create any kind of analytics charts. If you have a license to supply chain control tower, you can also have custom alerts, which are web-based alerts, right? A dedicated process management activity can be also configured, meaning that those different activities, what individual planner covers within demand or within supply review or within IRMDR, can be mapped within a specific app using IBP, and then a subsequent activity can be ticked off. Right? So process management part is also available. It is up to clients whether to use it or not. Some people use email exchanges or any additional tools like JAM, etc., SAP JAM, etc., for this collaboration. But we still have process management part available. And we also talked about alerts. On the below part, I mentioned about SAP JAM. It's one of the collaboration tool which can be used to have a smooth collaboration within different community of planners or within different departments, right? So we can utilize this tool to have this smooth synchronization so that the S&OP cycle moves smoothly without any bottlenecks. So that additional tool has been also provided by SAP. You will require a related license again for that. On the right side, what we are talking about is different UIs, right? Front end from planning perspective. Mostly Excel UI is used by all the planners as it's user friendly. It's very simple to manage. In addition to that, SAP has also provided web UI. When we say web UI, if you have experience on SAP Fiori apps, similar Fiori apps are also available in SAP IBP web UI. So you can click on those apps to have a dedicated function enabled. For example, if I want to set up my product lifecycle management, if there is an NPI, I need to set up my reference material and tag it to the new material so that sales history of reference material is used for generating the statistical forecast of new material, right? So such kind of enablement happens via the specific app within web. You being consultant, you configure the system. While configuring the system, we use different apps within web UI, right? There is a model configuration app where you generate planning area, you create new attributes or key figures, etc. Also, you set up your roles and authorizations using specific apps within web. So there are different usages of Excel, mostly from planner perspective. Web, it's combined for client consultant perspective, also from planner perspective. Right, and then SAP has also enabled the synchronization with mobile, right? So you can use your iPhone, just connect your attach your mobile to the IBP. You can review your alerts, you can review your analytics, you can also access SAP Jam and have a smooth collaboration, right? Those are different types of UIs which are available, which we discussed on the right side of the slide. On the left side of the slide, how does IBP integrate with different systems, right? So more common, any ECC, ERP, S4, right? Since we are talking about time series data transfer here, or S&OP being used for time series analysis, SAP requires a middleware, which is called as CPIDS, Cloud Platform Integration for Data Services. It's a middleware which is used as an ETL tool, right? Extract data from your source system, transform it to the format what IBP respect, and then load it into IBP, either in terms of master data or in terms of transactional data, like key figures. So one would also need some knowledge how CPIDS would work if we want to be an independent consultant, right? So first of all, learning IBP, and then also learning bit logic of CPIDS. Probably you being experienced into a APO as a functional consultant, you were responsible for creating specifications or functional specifications, you can say that, right? The logic, how the customization needs to happen. So similarly, with that experience, with that logic understanding, you can also understand CPIDS functionalities. You don't need to have a coding experience or a technical experience here, but you should be able to work closely with the technical person while deciding this transformation logic. This is how IBP gets integrated with other systems, right? So there is a mutual integration inbound to IBP as well as outbound to IBP. So when we say inbound to IBP, master data comes from ECC system into IBP as an example. Whereas once we generate the planning results, the transactional data can also be transformed back to any other, either whether it is ECC for execution or for APO for further refinement, or to BW for any reporting, or to any cloud-based reporting tools like ClickSense or AWS, etc. This is how you would visualize the architecture for IBP, right? Next discussions will be in more details. What do we cover in demand planning as an independent model? What do we cover as a supply planning as an independent model, and so on? So with this, I will stop here on the discussion of IBP overview, and then Parvinder can take it ahead.
Thank you. Thank you, Sam. And I have answered some of the questions already in the chat window. So you can try to find your answers. Someone is asking that when we will be starting the training. So we'll be doing IBP training into the two batches. First batch would be for the demand planning, S&OP demand planning, and second batch would be for the supply planning. Okay. And we are looking for the server. As soon as the server get available, we would be able to start the batch, but it will take, you can assume that it will take 2 months to start minimum. When we are planning from now, it will take 2 months to start. So we can have a target to get it started in the month of April for the IBP training. But before the April, we will be having two more sessions where basically we'll go a little bit more deeper into the demand planning, one session, and a little bit more deeper into the supply planning. One more session, we'll be doing it Thursday, 7 p.m.